Hi, welcome to the podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start conversation on Unit 18, Constitutional Provisions and Educational Policies in India. And we are going to continue our topic, Constitutional Provisions regarding Education. And we shall discuss the list in the Constitution. The first list is Union List. Entry 63. Institutions known at the commencement of the Constitution as Banaras Hindu University, Aligarh Muslim University and Delhi University. The universities established in pursuance of the Article 371E. Any other institution declared by Parliament by law to be an institution of national importance are included in this list. Later on, other institutions too have been included in this list. Entry 64. Institutions of scientific or technical education financed by the Government of India wholly or in part and declared by Parliament by law to be institution of national importance. Entry 65. Union agencies and institutions for professional, vocational and technical training, including the training of police officers or the promotion of special studies or research or scientific or technical assistance in the investigation or detection of crime. Article 66. Coordination and determination of standards in institutions for higher education or research and scientific and technical institution. List 2, State List. This list includes educational issues of the state including universities. Entry 12. Libraries, museums and other such institutions controlled and financed by the states, ancient and historical monuments and records other than those declared to be of national importance. List 3, Concurrent List. Entry 20. This provision has an indirect but significant bearing on education and is concerned with economic and social planning. Education planning being an essential element of economic and social planning, the Government of India and the State Government are to work together in preparing and implementing the national plans for the reconstruction of education. Entry 25, Vocational and Technical Training of Labor. Article 350A facilitates for instruction in mother tongue at primary stage. This article requires the government to safeguard the interest of the children belonging to linguistic minority groups and to ensure adequate facilities for them to receive at least primary education through their mother tongue. Article 351 places a special responsibility on Government of India for promoting the spread of Hindi language and its development so that it may serve as a medium of expression for all in the composite culture of India. Article 343 deals with the official language of Union. This article states that the official language of Union shall be Hindi in Devanagari script. The form of numeral to be used for the official purposes of Union shall be the international form of Indian numerals. Notwithstanding anything in clause 1, for a period of 15 years from the commencement of this constitution, English language shall continue. At present, Hindi is the official language of the Union of India and English is the associate official language. Thus, the constitution has provisions to regulate the language policies to be implemented in schools. Article 15 prohibits discrimination on ground of religion, race, caste, sex or place of birth. The third clause of this article empowers the state to make special provisions for women and children, and this includes education too. Now let us move to the next point, educational policies. Now that we are aware of the constitutional provisions regarding education, let us discuss some of the major national policies on education. The Government of India, through its various agencies, formulates policy on education and also revises them. We know that Republic of India is governed on the basis of the Constitution of India, which came into force on 26th January 1950. Educational policies are framed by various agencies of the central as well as the state governments in the perspective of the provisions in the Constitution. The policies framed by the agencies of the central government have a national jurisdiction and prevail over the policies framed by the state in case of conflict between them. These policies have a direct role in shaping the educational scenario and assist educational administration by ruling out doubts and ambiguities. The constitutional provisions were framed by BAC, but since then, with the changing socio-economic milieu, there has been new thinking on social issues including education. Therefore, to comply with the demands of the changed socio-economic order, the country, and also to cope with those put forth by a changing global situation, policies on education have been changing. To accommodate these changes, the constitutional provisions regarding education too have been amended from time to time. Therefore, the policies on education are dynamic in nature and are framed to respond to the existing political, social, economic and cultural needs of the society. Policy decisions on individual issues can also be taken by the government or its agencies as and when felt necessary in the form of resolutions, schemes, guidelines, orders, etc. The policies framed are a reflection of the existing philosophy of education and strongly display the outlook of society and especially of the government regarding educational issues. Apart from the constitution that has provisions on education, educational policies are also articulated through legislations. Some of the important central legislations have been a bearing on the subjects allotted to the Department of Secondary and Higher Education are. The University Grant Commission Act 1956. The University Grant Commission UGC was established through this act to regulate important issues pertaining to the functioning of the university. The All India Council for Technical Education Act 1987. It led to the establishment of an All India Council for Technical Education, basically for the proper planning and coordinated development of the technical education system in India. The National Council for Teacher Education Act 1993. It led to the establishment of a National Council for Teacher Education for achieving planned and coordinated development of teacher education system. The regulation and the proper maintenance of norms and standards in the teacher education system and for other related matters. The National Council for Minority Educational Institutions Act 2004. This act regulates the educational institutions of the minorities of India. The Copyright Act 1973. 1957. This act is regarding the various aspects related to the copyright of literary, artistic and architectural and other such aspects. The Apprentices Act 1961. This act is regarding apprentices and their training. The Persons and the Disabilities Act 1995. Equal opportunities, protection of rights and full participation. This act is an important step in ensuring equal opportunities for people with disabilities and their full participation in nation building. We thus see that the policies on education emerge mainly from the constitution and also from the legislation or agencies of the government. Now let us discuss some of the major policies on education in our next conversation. Here we wind up this conversation, and thank you so much for choosing this podcast.